Hello and welcome to this little how-to guide, which serves as an addition to my previous video. And for everyone who is new here, I'll shortly explain what this is all about. And for this reason, I will show you quickly again what the program actually does. So jumping in here, I'm starting it from my code off to not have this window switch to my secondary monitor. Whoever wants to see how that looks, you can just refer to the previous video and you'll see how it automatically switches to the second monitor to move this browser window with the map over there. So yeah, the purpose of this program is to have the new world map automatically follow you in your game. So it will read the position of the in-game position and then move the map accordingly and have that all on the secondary monitor, so you always see what's around you. And I was asked by a comment in the previous video to show you how you can use this and how you can get it, and I've prepared some little tutorial for that. But for now, to show you real quick how this actually functions again, I'm gonna open the screenshot. I was standing here in Brightwood. This should already have been enough for the program to read the position, and you see this map already got there. I was a bit too slow, but it found the position in Brightwood. If you want some further input on that, you can also refer to the previous video. And moving in now, how you can get this to work for yourself. I have written a small guide on how to do this. Small might be a bit of an understatement, but let's just dive into it. So basically, you need to download the program itself plus the configuration file, and also some software that will allow this program to work. For the first link, you can just download all the files from my side on a Google Drive. I'll put the link in the description down below. And the second link will be a framework that allows me to read the text position from an image using the Python language, Python programming language, and this is called Tesseract. It's from the University of Mannheim in Germany, and it's really nice, functions pretty good. And for the last download, you need to download the Chrome driver, and this will only work with Google Chrome for now. That's just how I've set it up, and here there are some specifics in the README file on which version you need to choose and how you can actually find the version of your Google Chrome. And yeah, that's basically it for the downloads. We can jump back into the guide. So for the setup, of course, you need two monitors for this to work. And you download all the files. You need to unzip the download from Google Chrome, which also has the README file inside of it. And then you have some directory on your machine that will look like this with these two files in it. Once you download the Chrome driver, you have to unzip that and put that in the same directory. So you have these three in one directory. And for the Tesseract framework, you need to download the installer from this site right here. You can choose which system you have, probably 64-bit environment for your Windows system. And yeah, once that's installed, you have to add the path that's stated right here, and where you have to install it under, to your system environment variables, so the program can actually find this framework to use the executable files in there. And how this is done, I've also provided a small guide on how to add something to your system environment variables for anyone that doesn't already know how to do this. But I'll not go in depth on how this works. You can just refer to the links within the README file. And yeah, once you have that set up, you're pretty much ready to go. But another step you have to consider is the configuration file. This will depend on your monitor setup. Okay, so for this, you have to consider your screens. And yeah, for myself, it's just a 1440p main screen and a 1080p secondary screen. And I do have it set up so that my secondary screen is not at a corner, but somewhere in the middle. So where my mouse right now is probably where the other starts approximately, which will be the height offset. This is used to position the window on your secondary screen. If you have the same dimensions on both of your screens, the height offset needs to be zero. And once you've edited those, you can just go ahead and run the mapcontroller.exe. I can do that real quick for me here, so you see how this looks. So this will start a terminal window, and let's wait a second. Here, it will start the browser window. Now it shifted it over to my secondary monitor, which you can't see right now. But this output right here is not of any concern. You can just minimize that, and you will see that the browser will automatically select some of the options of New World Maps to display chests, ores, some of the plants, and yeah, just what I found useful personally. And if you're in game, you also need to turn on your FPS, which can be done going to the settings and then visuals tab on the left side, and then you scroll down to show FPS, and this must be on. So you have this position in the top right. And that's all you have to do. You can now check out if this works for you. A little something to remember: you cannot manually resize the window of the browser, or else this will break, sadly. But I personally did not yet find any need to resize that. Half of the screen of my secondary monitor was, for me at least, enough. You can still use the map and scroll in, for example, or use the filters. This will all still work. Let's check it again. Yeah, it found the position and it's already moving now. So it will take in the latest position it saw to then move there, because it sometimes is really hard in game to read the position. So if it is successful one time, then it will take this value in to move to the right position. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this. If you want to close the program again, just go ahead and take the terminal window and hit the X. This will output some text you can also disregard. It will automatically close the browser, and the program is done. And that's it. Pretty simple, actually, just a few steps. It might seem a bit scary at first if you're not familiar with how to handle a computer very well, but I'm pretty certain this README file will help you with any questions you might have. That's all from my side. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye.